focus is on cutting-edge domain knowledge and benchmarking with world-class business.
Big Tech. We are at Auto Expo 2018 and we have with us Director General of SIAM, Mr. Vishnu Mathur, who has successfully organized 3 Auto Expos at Greater Noida's India Expo Mart Limited for the last 3 years. This year's edition was very praiseworthy for the audience who have liked the different pavilions. There was different experience zones as well as a lot of focus was there on the safety of drivers and genuine parts being used for the vehicles. We will be speaking to Director General Mr. Vishnu Mathur and will know more facets about this particular expo. Sir, speaking about this year's expo, what was the response of the manufacturers who have communicated with somebody? So how was their response?
No, I think the response was excellent. It is never the case that all manufacturers come in every show. So there have been companies missing in the previous shows and there are companies missing in this show also. But overall, the response has been excellent. There are new players who have come in, companies which are just going to set up manufacturing in India for the first time,
like Kia.
So they have used this opportunity of unveiling all their models and showing to us what they will be manufacturing in India, what they'll be offering to the Indian customer. In addition to that, most of the companies have for the first time commercially launched models of electric vehicles. As you all know that, you know, electric vehicles, electric mobility is a priority for the country today. The government as well as the industry, all of us are looking towards moving electric, largely because of emission issues, pollution issues, energy security. So this is a future mobility. And you will find that in the previous expos, while we have been showcasing concepts and concept pavilions, this time in every stall there was a bit of electric. In some of the pavilions there were more of electric, and we are talking about electric not only cars but also two-wheelers, also public transport, buses, different concepts of battery swapping, and different kinds of technologies are being shown because electric is the new mobility era that we are seeing.
So electric and hybrid is going to be the future of mobility. So going by the visitors acknowledgement, visitors count, so how do you see there, how was the visitors response for this particular edition of Auto?
Well, the visitor response, let me say, right from 2014 has been excellent. When we came here for the first time in 2014, people were saying that, you know, it's too far and how will people come, and I think at the end of the show everyone said we were wrong. And I think that kind of response to the show has continued in 2016 and also in 2018 now. So I must thank the people of this country for their love for automobile, which brings them even long distances outside the cities. You also have local people here. There's the local population in Noida, which is also extremely good. So we are grateful to all of them for making Auto Expo a great show. And I think when we get the details of the actual number count for the dates, we will be disclosing the numbers also.
So do you perceive the recent policy changes like GST and demonetization had any effect on the footfalls or the manufacturer participation?
I don't think so. I think the footfalls are not governed by GST, because on each step taken you don't pay a GST, fortunately. So I think the footfalls and the kind of people who come to visit the show is more about passion, is more about the emotional involvement with this industry rather than a taxation issue or things like that. But yes, as you mentioned, demonetization did have a temporary impact on the industry last year. And after that, it was very quick to come back. I think it recovered very quickly because this is a very resilient industry. And I don't think we can keep this industry bogged down for too long.
So as you have already mentioned, some big brands like Audi or Volkswagen were missing from this year's expo. And there were a lot of curiosity around that thing. So what would be your comment on those participants missing?
No, I really am not anybody to comment on the individual decision of a company. But when we asked companies why or what are the reasons for them not participating, I think largely the reasons are coming out to be that the product development cycle is not in tune with the timing of the Auto Expo. So they have products in the pipeline, they have products being developed, but if they're not able to get it ready by the Auto Expo, then they may not participate, and that's probably what has happened. So it's not that you will not see these companies launching products. These companies may not be in Auto Expo, but I think during the next few months you will still see product launches from these companies.
Sir, this was the third edition that happened in Greater Noida. So what's your take on the support that you got from UP government or the district administration and Greater Noida authority in particular?
I have only one word: outstanding.
Oh,
I think this, the administration here, the Noida Authority, the Fairground, the IEML have been really good, and we have got wonderful support from everybody, including the administration, the police, and all the administrative agencies. You just go outside the fairgrounds and you will find so much of cleanliness. You see the traffic management being done so beautifully. I mean, there is absolutely no jams. There is no problem in people entering, and you have lakhs, hundreds of thousands of people entering. So I think the overall arrangements by the authority, the administration, has been outstanding, and I must really thank them on behalf of SIAM and the industry as a whole, and the other organizers, ACMA and CII.
Sir, one last question that everybody in Greater Noida is very curious to know. Is it happening in Greater Noida in 2020?
We hope so, and we'll come back to you with the details.
Okay. So thank you very much for speaking to 10 years, sir. So that was DG SIAM, Mr. Vishnu Mathur, who told us about various aspects of Auto Expo 2018. As you have already seen with our coverage, this Auto Expo 2018 was very fascinating and full of excitement for the audience. The expo is ending today, but the launches that have happened will be hitting market in next few months, and we will keep you updated with that as well. With camera person Rohit Sharma, Ashish Kedia for 10 years.